Alrighty.
So, inadvertently stopped the video, so this is, I guess, gonna be part two. Didn't mean to do it, but.
Well.
Not where you're here. Basically, just doing enough exercise to keep the muscle toned, but at the same time, give me some rest on the elbow. I may actually have to break down and get myself a brace. Well, for the time being, I had to do it with my leg when I was throwing discus, and it was just so I could keep practicing without doing any more damage. So, probably maybe tomorrow before I go into the workout, I might try to get there. Elbow sleeve if they have one big enough for me. Great. I'll kick it up a little bit more and tap another side. What this does is just isolates my arm so there's no, you know, lacking, there's no back thrust, shoulder thrust, or any of that. So you're just really locking in, isolating the muscle.
So what I'm doing here is just a pull down rep, I'm decreasing the weight because I want to get blood pumped to the area which needs to be in. The best way to do it is to just do a lightweight and a high rep, and it's going to force the circulation into that area, which is going to carry the nutrients and the building blocks to repair the area that's damaged. Because that's what pain is selling, is an area that got damaged. So you can either ignore it, damage it more, or you can ignore it and do nothing. Or you can work out accordingly and do some exercise that will actually help in the healing of it and still not lose any strength. So there are times for lightweight, high rep exercises, even as a routine is for geared for powerlifting. So I definitely got a lot of blood pumped into the muscle. Alright. And it's going to carry the nutrients to the area that needs healing. Alright, time for the workout. Try this.
How you doing? Oh, you turned the fans down? Well, I didn't know you could do that.
They're talking off, but I figure with a lot of viruses going on, you know, I just kind of hate the.
All right, yeah.